Hey, Gaylerd here. Hey, welcome back to the 30-Day Challenge. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you some accent strumming techniques because not only do you need to learn how to play chords and how to transition between those chords, you need to know how to accent the strumming to each and every song differently. And the way you do that is by listening to the beat, the intent of the song, the heart of the song, and strumming those chords, giving accents to the words and the beats that you hear. You may play it differently each time, but your audience will hear that and feel it the same way you do, okay? So here's what I want you to start off doing. Remember, in accent strumming, you've got to start off by making sure that you can play all six strings nice and clean with the least amount of resistance. And by that I mean that we had that lesson earlier on the pick. Don't hold that pick so tight. Don't squeeze that tight to where you're just picking it. I've seen a lot of people hold that pick like this. Okay, and then they're picking, and they're picking it like, let's see if I can show you here. That's just not good. We want that regular Big Dawg guitar picking style that I showed you. And what I want you to be able to do is just hold that pick nice and smooth, just nice and lightly in there, okay? Like you don't want to crush it or break it. And just strum those strings all the way through, all six strings. And what I want you to do, the first thing I want you to do is just play a G chord and get used to lifting just those two fingers down here, lifting them up and putting them back down. Now, if you'll notice, there's my strumming right there. I'm not changing that strumming. But listen to the way it sounds. Strumming's the same, pattern's the same, but lifting up those fingers makes all the difference. Now, accent strumming is made up of three areas of motion. It's in your arm, okay? And that's used the least amount of times ever, is in your arm. I rarely use my arm. If you see my arm moving, it's just accidental, I guess, almost. Because most of the time when I'm playing, I'm going to base my fingers. I'm going to take my pinky, and I'm going to put it right down here somewhere around on this pick guard and stationary my hand so I can just use my wrist and my fingers. So my arm that you use, if you see somebody going like this, I'm always watching guys play guitar. When I see them going like this, I know they're probably holding that pick wrong. And they're holding, and they're getting too much resistance when they're playing on those strings, and it's going to be hard to play any little licks and riffs and runs and fills. So hold that pick nice and smooth, be able to play it through there. Open up. There's the arm motion. Normally, the only time that I'm using my arm is if I want to get some kind of attention. Like at the end of a song, a lot of times we'll do something like that, you know, or really getting attention. A lot of big ending on a song is what my vocalist says. Oh, there's always, everybody loves a big ending. And when I'm doing that, my hand is going up and I'm stiff arming it almost to get that hard sound out of it. Other than that, my arm is really not coming into play very much. Most of the motion that I get in Big Dawg guitar strumming and accent strumming comes from my wrist. Now, that's all it is in my wrist. When I'm playing chords, I'm just playing it nice and smooth with the wrist. The other motion comes with the brush on the fingers. My index finger and my thumb, all I'm doing is really just brushing like a brush stroke on those strings. I just want to color the strings with that brush. So it's almost in combination with my wrist. My fingers are moving at the same time, kind of like you're turning a key. I guess that's how you could talk about, like turning a key or painting on a canvas, just back and forth. And let me show you what I'm talking about on the thumb and the index finger back and forth motion. For instance, if I'm painting a note, okay, I can go back and forth on that note. And all I'm doing is painting that canvas, painting those strings back and forth. has that nice smooth wrist motion, and you're using that wrist in combination with your fingers, okay? You'll get used to doing that. That wrist is the main thing that you want to do, but if you have your fingers not stiff, if they're not stiff, they're going to be loose like that. When you're playing, it'll all come into a nice clean motion. So you could play your chords C, D, E minor, and G. Going to be your accent strumming. It's all coming in with the notes and the chords. Nice, clean motions. Soft, fluid motions with your wrist and your finger and occasionally your arm. But make sure that your arm is not doing this. If your arm is what's stroking the strings, now you're going to have a little bit of an issue when you come to Big Dawg guitar playing. Just the wrist and paint those strings. Because you can do so much. That's where your is all 14 of those chords that you learned earlier. I want you to play all 14 of those chords with that strumming motion, making sure that you're using your wrist and painting that brush. Paint that canvas. Paint the strings with your finger and your thumb. And change all 14 of those chords.